A very good afternoon to the members of the media. There are a couple of reasons why we are having this press conference, and we'll go according to that. The first one is about our Operation Kakana that we launched, and the step that the Ministry of Health has taken in order to advise public on the aftermath of the recent flooding and the precautions that the public needs to take and what actions we are taking. In terms of Operation Kakana, I think we are all aware that we are in the midst of a festive season, Christmas and New Year approaching, and there's a lot of food safety risks that we anticipate that is normally associated with festivities, and our focus is basically on public health, and it's not only now, but we are normally inundated with calls about from the consumers about the quality of food that is normally sold during this festive season. So Operation Kakana was launched earlier this month, and the whole aim of this is to work with the Food Safety Act 2003 and the Food Safety Regulations of 2009 to ensure that the food that is sold in our eateries, our restaurants, our roadside canteens are acceptable, safe, and of good quality for our people to consume. And we also would like to protect our consumers from deception and possibly food frauds. During this season, it's not only waterborne diseases that that people normally suffer from, but there are a lot of foodborne diseases too. So Operation Kakana is basically going to target on food safety. And we'd also like to get our consumers to make informed choices about where to eat from, what to eat from, and of course encouraging people to come forward with complaints should they not be satisfied with the food safety standards that we are trying to bring up. And also we are going to strictly look into fair trading practices when it comes to food. On this note, in collaboration with the Ministry of Local Government, the City and Town Council health officers, we have embarked on this operation to address food safety issues pertinent to public health, and of course we want to protect all our consumers. This is an ongoing operation, and it's always been an operation within the Ministry, but we are trying to intensify our efforts to promote safe and quality food that is going to be made available for the public. And this also includes, many a times we tend to forget that a lot of food preparation is done within the homes, a lot of slaughters are done within individual homes and backyards, and these are also sold to the public on a door-to-door basis. At the end of the day, it's going to be the choice that the public is going to make, but we are here to ensure that the choices that they make are informed and it does not put any risk to their families at the same time. Looking at the complaints that we receive, it ranges from absence of basic good hygiene practices, okay, poor general cleanness of the eateries and restaurants, presence of flies, insects, rodents, and sometimes the building structures are not maintained, the convenience facilities are not maintained, you have poor and the quality of the utensils that is used to prepare the food is also not acceptable and conducive to good food practices, and basic general housekeeping matters. And we believe that during such festive seasons, there's going to be an influx of people out there who would want to go out with their families and eat out. And of course, when these standards are not complied to, not only does it become uncomfortable for the people to take their families and eat out, it is a lot of health issues that needs to be addressed. Most importantly, we want to avoid food poisoning and other health impacts. So in order to ensure that our consumers are satisfied with the service that they get and the environment is safe, pleasant, as required by law, where families and individuals can enjoy their meals without any fear of being getting sick or ending up in a hospital, this operation, the efforts are going to be intensified. The level of surveillance effort varies depending on the assessed level of risk. And from the beginning of this month, we have been visiting, the team has been out, not only in Suva, but in the Northern Division, the Western Division. So it's a national operation. We have our teams out there. We have the Consumer Council also working with us. where their members are also out there on the ground and reporting to us what is happening. And especially in times when we have just, when we are just recovering from a flood, this is equally important, because I'm sure very soon we will be having a lot of flood sales going on. So consumers, again, need to be very vigilant in what they choose to buy. And probably for traders, we would expect they do not engage in practices where they put the health and safety of our people at risk over profits. A lot of things that might have been damaged, we expect to see them being sold under that flood sale banner. So the advice to the public is, put your health first. And advice to the traders is, let us not compromise health over profits. If things have to be discarded, the onus lies on the traders to discard those products that should, that are not satisfactory for human consumption. So I'd like to appeal to the traders as well. Please do not compromise the health of our people. Discard those things that have been damaged in the floods and allow our consumers to have a healthy festive season. And the key message again, and we must all, including the media, give out messages that is going to protect our people. You play a very important role, and I'm sure you will assist us by taking our message out to the public to make healthy choices. While we are on food safety, it's also important that during this festive season, families also practice good hygiene when preparing food. We empathize and we also sympathize with those families who are going through this, who have been affected by this recent flooding, who have also sustained damages to their homes, to their properties. But we will need to do our share to recover from that. And simple cooking practices that are that will lead to healthy practices must be practiced within our homes too. I'm sure during flooding there would be a lot of death of livestock, and we'd like to encourage public to ensure that they are buried accordingly. We cannot have dead livestock lying around our compounds or drains or rivers. So we would like to request the public to come on board to assist us with that. Of course, the priority should be cleaning their homes first, the welfare of the families first. But then there are certain members within the communities that might not have been affected by this. So we'd like everybody to come up on board and clean up their homes and communities. So basically that, and should people get sick, our hospitals and health centers are open to provide services, and we'd like them to visit our hospitals and health centers for any medical advice that they need in terms of that, whether it's food poisoning or whether it's any sickness related to this adverse weather conditions. I think Deep will talk about the penalties that are in place for those traders who do not comply with the legislations and requirements under the Food Safety Act and the food safety regulations, and we are going to come down really hard on those people who do not comply with this and put the lives of our Fijian families at risk in terms of preparing food, in terms of selling food, you know, in terms of not meeting up the standards of the levels that is expected from them in order to provide such services. So all in all, we'd like to wish everybody a happy Merry Christmas. I know some of the communities will have a very bleak Christmas, but we all need to pitch in together and see how best we can assist each other to recover from that.